So now that the crystals are all placed and all set, I made a few little minor adjustments that I didn't want to bore you with. So now we have to paint the interior before we put the pieces together. Otherwise, it's impossible to paint the interior. And we want to get thick enough to get a nice, creamy, even coat, and also to fill in the little gaps between the pieces in here. So I'm going to do 3, possibly 4 coats on the facing here, and 2 coats on the little window bits, because I want them to start out white, and I will paint them gold when we paint the exterior. In painting the interior, I bring the paint up the crystals just a little bit, about the same amount as I brought the glue up when I was securing the crystals. So this is just really repetitive, really boring work, and I'm going to do it all on fast forward for you. Okay, so the interior of the mechanism is now completely painted. Now I use a titanium white with just a tad of lavender in there. So it's just a slight off-white that you can't really tell until the mechanism is put together and it's painted on the outside. Then you can see that there's just this slight essence of lavender. So now we put them together, two halves together. And fortunately it fits pretty well and there's not going to be too much difficulty. Now putting them together, and this is where they join, okay? And there is a dip in here. So when the two of them go together, there's this sort of large hollow space between the two. And that means that if I were to just glue it as it is, it would have a very fragile bond. It would not be making good contact. It wouldn't survive for very long. So what I do is I put a little bit of paper clay in each of these spaces and then mush the top down on top, make sure it all molds nicely, take the top off, let this paper clay dry, which I've glued in here. And once the paper clay has dried and shrunk a little bit, I then glue the top on there and apply pressure. Okay? So I will go ahead and do that. Doesn't take very much glue, doesn't take very much paper clay either. I've got a thin little coil. And I just want to lay enough glue in here for the paper clay to grab hold of. So I don't want it coming out. So I'll take a little piece of paper, little coil of paper clay, mush it down in here just a bit. Don't want to distort it too much at this stage. But you want it to go down in that crevice and fill it. Okay. And rise up just a little bit. Bits of paper clay are all in there now. Now let that sit for just a moment and then we will put the top on. Okay. Now I'm going to put this on and make good contact. Make sure it's all lined up perfectly. Press it all together. Kind of doing what the dentist does when he takes a mold of your teeth or fits you for dentures. Molding the top of that paper clay to fit perfectly into the gap that we're trying to fill here. Okay. take that off. Alrighty. And we have indented the paper clay a little bit. So when I put glue on here, it will make good contact with this surface when it comes to putting it together. So I'm going to let this paper clay set up for a while, maybe a half hour, 45 minutes, see how it goes with the drying, and then we put the two halves together. Okay, so the paper clay has set up very nicely. It's just right, I'd say. So now I'm going to slop a bunch of glue on here. Well, not slop, but I'm going to put some glue on here. Now, in joining something this important, you use full strength Pinol, or whatever glue you're using. You don't want to dilute it. And this is full strength in here. So now, we don't want to put too much glue, because it'll just ooze out all over the place. But we want to get enough in here to make a good bond. And we want to bring the glue right out to the very edge here, because this is part of where things need to connect. Okay, get some on there. Okay, that's good enough there. I'm going to put some glue on the other connecting part here as well. But now, that's good for there. Now I'll put some in here. Okay, now we want this glue to get pretty sticky before we put things together here. There's the yeast. Yes. There's yeast. in doing something like this, it's better to let both the glued areas get tacky and really sticky before putting them together. If it's really wet still, it's slippery and it's less, it's more uncontrollable. Okay? So by having it nice and sticky, when I lay it in, it doesn't move around as much. It'll be easier for me to get it precisely where I need it. So I am going to get some tape ready because I think I'm going to need some tape on this one. Looking really good. So, just going 6 p.m. here in Berlin on Monday, the 8th of December, and this is the last radiator mechanism going together. This side needs to be pressed together because it came a little misshapen over the making of things. Looking good. No glue is squirting out anywhere at me. Good positioning here. Okay. pressure on there for a little while. This is actually even probably more precarious than it looks. So don't do this at home. That's good. Okay, now we're going to leave that pressure on there for a few minutes. Not too long, because usually it's just too scary to leave it this way for very long. So, the mechanism is joined. Okay, so our joining has dried and solidified overnight, and it's really good. There doesn't seem to be anything out of whack. All the crystals are touching, the central sphere is held in place. So next, there are each of these little windows here, there are these little gaps in the corners where I've joined. And so we're going to fill those with a little bit of paper clay, make it a nice smooth little corner there. And back in here, you'll see this little line. And this is, again, the interior spot where it's joined. And there's a little gap there. Now, some of these we're going to be able to fill just with paint. But one of them, I'm going to have to put a little bit of paper clay in there to fill it as well. So that's what I'm going to do. And it's a very simple process. Little bits of paper clay and glue and paint. Let's see, brush. Okay, it takes just a tiny little bit of paper clay for this. And we just stick a little bit of glue in there first. In the crevice. Just a little tiny little bit. There's a handy little tool to really shove it in that little hole. So I'm going to do that on all the rest, and there's no point in taking you through it all in regular speed. So it's going to be all on fast forward.